team, this is Nathan from RunDreamAchieve.com. Hope you're all having a great week. Today's topic, I just wanted to make a video on knee injuries from running and how to cope with that. The reason why I'm making this video is because I fully understand the complexities of dealing with injuries. I've dealt with many injuries over the years, and knee injuries is definitely one of them. I've had three knee injuries, three knee surgeries as well. They had to go in twice on my left knee. I broke off some cartilage back in 96 or 90 or 97. I think 97 was the last surgery I had, where cartilage just kept breaking off in my knees. And so a lot of this, I think, is a mixture of genetics as well as just spending too much time running on hard surfaces, concrete. Fortunately for me, I never had any issues after 1997, whereas, you know, in regards to knee-related injuries that needed surgeries. Okay, so if you're dealing with these things, if you're running, you're out running, and you feel like your knee locks up, and you'll know for certain if it's a piece of cartilage that broke off in your knee. Dealing with knee injuries and how to cope with knee injuries from running, the best advice I can give you is, without question, don't continue to run on any type of injury related to your knees. If it continues, if it becomes chronic, if you feel like when you're out running and you feel your knee is locking up, definitely stop immediately. Get an x-ray and find out for certain if there is any floating, we call them, in the sports medicine field, we call it floating bodies. So the good news is, if it's a floating body or a piece of cartilage that broke off in your kneecap, a sports medicine doc can go in and remove that with surgery. But the good news is, it's a type of surgery that you can recover from very quickly. When I had my knee surgeries, it was orthoscopic knee surgeries, I was able to basically go back out and run after about 6 weeks. You know, you're gonna be on crutches for anywhere from a month to 6 weeks, for, you know, maybe a little bit longer than that, but right around that time frame. So the good news is, orthoscopic knee surgeries you can definitely recover from quickly, but do not be in a rush. The reason why they had to go in twice on my left knee is because the doc did tell me you can start very easy jogging 4 weeks, you know, about a month after the surgery. So I listened to his advice, and exactly 4 weeks later, I started jogging. And sure enough, I went out for another run. It happened again. I felt another piece of cartilage break off in my kneecap when I was out jogging. So don't be in a rush. If you do have to have surgery and you do have to go in and have that removed, then give yourself more. If the doc says a month, give yourself 3 months. Again, it's much, much wiser to give yourself more time than that's needed than to, you know, try to be motivated and highly motivated and driven and jump back out into training only to sideline yourself for another several months because you were too much in a rush in your training. So, and trying to get back out on the roads. So you do have to be very smart in your preparation when it comes to any type of knee-related injury. Over the years too, I had patellar tendonitis as well. So patellar tendonitis is a type of injury you can run through. Patellar tendonitis, you know, you can get one of those patellar straps. I ran with those when I was in high school and my first couple years in college as well. Patellar tendonitis, you can definitely run through. My best recommendations for you all in regards to that, if you're dealing with patellar tendonitis, make sure you're icing. You can take styrofoam cups, fill styrofoam cups with water, put it in your freezer, and then you can make massage. You basically just massage your knees 15 to 20 minutes a couple times a day. And that alleviates a lot of the soreness that comes with patellar tendonitis. You can run through it, but it's a pain in the ass definitely to deal with that. And in regards to patellar tendonitis, again, don't think that that's gonna go away in a matter of a few weeks. I dealt with patellar tendonitis for several months. It comes and goes. the main thing is just to maintain your motivation and drive. Know that in this cycle of success, that great success is gonna take work. It's gonna take some ups and downs along the way. Again, you're gonna be tested in the sport. Even looking back at my own career, I had great events, great races, great performances, but I had a lot of setbacks as well. And the key thing is I never gave up. And the same goes for you. You have to accept the fact that what you're doing is going to take time, it's going to take effort, and there are going to be ups and downs. And knee injuries from running is just part of the process. I hope that the athletes that are watching this video, I hope you have never dealt with knee injuries, or you never have to experience that. And there are a lot of athletes that don't experience necessarily knee injuries, but they experience some other type of challenge, whether that's you're just out, you're out walking or out running, and all of a sudden you just get a bruise out of the blue, and you don't understand where it came from. The body is complex. It's some, you know, our physiology definitely challenges us with little injuries that pop up out of the blue, and we don't understand it. The key thing is to not lose enthusiasm. Know that the body will eventually heal itself. Our Creator definitely created a masterpiece with the body. Our immune system is strong. If you do get a cold or you do feel weak, you know, the best thing, hydrate, stock up on zinc, iron. Your body, if you're running low on, if you're feeling fatigued, your body might be running very, very low on iron or ferritin, magnesium, potassium. Make sure you're definitely paying attention to vitamin C, your nutrition. You know, I continue to reiterate nutritiongeeks.com, my other website where I focus a lot more on nutrition and business. Look at those specific areas of your training and your preparation, because a lot of times you can be, you know, if you're training and you're feeling fatigued all the time, or you're not having great workouts, or you're not having so much of great races, it could very well be you're running low on something, whether that's niacin, zinc, vitamin C, vitamin D3, your immune system might be weakened in regards to that. So keep those things in mind. When it comes to knee injuries from running, don't continue to go out the door and try to run on these types of injuries. Rest is the number one recommended plan. It's much, much better to take a couple months off than to risk making the injury worse and then forcing yourself to either have a surgery. You know, there are athletes out there that get patellar tendonitis, get Achilles tendonitis, or they get shin splints and they continue to run on it and it gets worse, or they unfortunately get to a point where they have to have a surgery. So there are some cases where you're definitely gonna have to have surgery. If it becomes a situation where you're out running and you do break off some cartilage off of your knee, like I did, and there's other athletes out there that have had arthroscopic knee surgeries. And again, the great news is those types of surgeries are very quick. You can recover from arthroscopic knee surgeries very, very fast, usually anywhere from 4 to 6 weeks. But just again, don't try to rush the process if you have experienced this and you have to take some time off. Again, it's much, much better to be smart and wise about your recovery and don't be in a rush than to be rushed and have to deal with several months or several weeks of additional downtime because you were so motivated to get out the door, like I was. That's the reason why I make this video, is I wanna make sure that if you're experiencing these types of setbacks in your preparation and you're dealing with a knee injury or you're dealing with any type of injury, whether that's a shin splint, like I said, over the years, I've had many, many injuries. I've had a ruptured plantaris tendon. I've had piriformis syndrome. I've had plantar fasciitis. I've had, like I said, the three knee surgeries where they had to go in twice on my left knee to remove floating bodies and once on my right knee, which it happened the same thing on my right knee as well. Again, sometimes it's just a matter of you're running, you're spending too much time putting in too much volume or putting in too much mileage. or even minimal mileage and you're just running on harder surfaces. So do everything you can to run on grass, run on dirt, get away from pavement or concrete as best as you can. Here in the United States of America, where most of our streets, most of our running surfaces are concrete or pavement, that's kind of like the environment we're faced with here in the States. But there are other locations around the world, Ethiopia, Kenya, other parts of the world where athletes are training more on softer surfaces. So they definitely have an advantage in that respect. If you have the option of running on Mondo or all surf or all terrain or a all surface track, rather than a concrete or a pavement track, definitely do it. Most of the Kenyans I've trained with over the years prefer grass tracks or dirt tracks. If they find a cinder track or dirt track, they'll train on that rather than a all-weather track or a Mondo track. So it just depends on the athlete, but when it comes to injuries revolved around your knees or any type of injury, make sure you're paying attention to recovery first. You're already motivated, you're already driven, otherwise you wouldn't even be watching this video. So the fact that you are tells me you've had some type of injury. So I understand where you're coming from because I've had them as well. But again, I've also had injuries. The reason why I had to deal with a longer amount of time off from training was because I was too high speed and too motivated to get back out the door and train when I really needed was to back off and allow myself time to recover and get beyond the ego and get beyond, I got to get back out there and I got to get back and on the track and I got to make sure I'm, you know, prepared to get ready for this race. There's always going to be other races. You got to be smart. Again, think about leverage. The best athletes don't always get the best results. It's the smartest athletes. It's the athletes that have the, they've learned from their mistakes. They understand that you don't rush the process. You don't rush getting healing from injuries. You have to allow downtime. You have to allow complete rest. If you're injured and you want to do some form of workouts and you're so, you know, ramped up and amped up and you want to get back out the door, the best recommended type of workout I would recommend to athletes that are dealing with any types of injuries that, you know, involve putting stress on ligaments or any type of that type of injury, get in the deep end of a pool and do pool running. Pool running doesn't involve any type of impact on your knees or on your ligaments or any type of the physiology of the body. You get in the deep end of the pool, you can still focus on doing pool running. There's no impact, like I said, so it's a great alternative as opposed to getting out the door when you're injured and trying to think and thinking that you're going to be able to run through an injury. It's very unwise to do that. So make sure you take this video to heart. If you have any other questions, concerns when it comes to either knee related injuries or any type of injuries, trust me, I understand. I've dealt with these and I also have other remedies and other options that are there for you if you want further information about injuries and how to overcome them, whether that's your mindset or your recovery or any type of nutritional questions you have, feel free to let me know in the comment section below. And I wish you guys and gals all the best in your training. Hopefully you're not experiencing any type of injuries currently, but if you are, this video is for you. I hope it was helpful in some respect as well. So I will talk to you all in the next video. I look forward to hearing from you, and I wish you all the best.